हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू केके वाघ पॉलिटेक्निक नासिक। माय सेल्फ योगिता जाधव, लेक्चरर इन फिजिक्स फ्रॉम साइंस एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज डिपार्टमेंट। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट। आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो यू आर एबल टू स्टेट द लॉज ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट। Before starting reflection of light, let us see some basic concept related to light. As we know that energy always appears in different forms. Light is one type of energy and it always travels in a straight line. If we consider speed of light, then speed of light in air or vacuum is always very high, that is 3 into 10 8 meter per second. Light always travels in the form of particles as well as wave. That means light shows both particle and wave nature. Now let us see reflection of light. This ray diagram shows reflection of light. This is the mirror surface. It is shown by this pointer. If ray of light is incident on this mirror surface, that is reflecting surface, then it bounces back in the same medium, and this phenomenon is called as reflection of light. When ray of light is falls on reflecting surface like mirror or it may be metal sheet also, then it bounces back in the same medium is called as reflection of light. Now here the ray which falls on reflecting surface is called as incident ray, and the ray which bounces back is called as reflected ray. If we draw perpendicular to this reflecting surface, then it is called as normal. This incident ray makes suitable angle with this normal. That angle is called as angle of incidence, which is represented by I letter. And here this refracted ray also makes some angle with the normal, then that is called as angle of reflection. And from this figure you observe that angle of incidence and angle of reflection is same. Now let us see the laws of reflection. First law of reflection is law of coplanarity. That is, the incident ray, reflected ray and normal all lies in the same plane. From the figure or ray diagram, we already observed that the angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. If I is angle of incidence, R is angle of reflection, then both our angles are always same in case of reflection. This is second law of reflection. Now when we consider angle of incidence and angle of reflection, then both are always measured with respect to normal to the reflecting surface. Now from this we define some terms, that is angle of incidence and angle of reflection. The angle which incident ray or line makes with perpendicular to the surface at the point of incidence, that we called as normal, is the angle of incidence, which always represented by small letter I. Angle of reflection is the angle made by reflected ray with normal to the reflecting surface, that is perpendicular to the reflecting surface, is called as angle of reflection, that is always represented by small letter r. And as we know that from the laws of reflection, angle of incidence always equal to angle of refraction. There are two types of reflections, regular reflection and irregular reflection, which is also called as diffuse reflection. Let us see first what do you mean by regular reflection. When a beam of light which is parallel, that means all the rays of light parallel to each other, is incident on smooth surface like mirror, then from this mirror surface this parallel beam of light is reflected such that all the reflected rays are also parallel to each other. This type of reflection is called as regular reflection. Second type of reflection is irregular reflection or diffuse reflection. In this case, when a parallel beam of light strikes on rough surface or incident on rough surface, such as surface of wall or maybe on book, then after reflection, the rays are scattered or they are reflected in different directions. They are not parallel to each other after reflection, and such type of reflection is called as irregular reflection, or it is also called as diffuse reflection. That means there are two types of reflections, regular and irregular reflection. Let us see what do you mean by refraction of light. Now suppose we consider the light is traveling from one medium to another medium. If we consider that here at upper position the medium is air medium, while this is suppose water medium or glass medium. When ray of light travels from one medium to another medium, that means air to glass, there is change in direction of the ray of light, and this phenomenon is known as refraction of light. The basic property of light is that it always travels in a straight line in a homogeneous medium, that is also known as rectilinear propagation of light. But whenever there is change in path, then there is change in direction. There is change in medium, then there is change in direction of light wave when it passes from one medium to another medium. Such a phenomenon is refraction of light, and this is the ray diagram of refraction of light. At this particular point, if we draw perpendicular to this refracting surface, then it is called as normal. This normal makes some angle with incident ray, that is angle of incidence. This normal makes some angle with refracted ray, that is known as angle of refraction. Here it angle of incidence and angle of refraction are also shown by small letter I and R respectively. Now let us see some examples of refraction in our daily life. Refraction is used by lens to form an image of an object for many purposes such as magnification. A spectrum of colors from incident beam of light is formed by prism using refraction. Light gets refracted through the prism, and due to the phenomenon of dispersion, the spectrum is obtained. Formation of mirrors, formation of rainbows, these are also examples of refraction in our daily life. Now let us see the refraction from rarer medium such as air to denser medium such as glass. This ray diagram shows refraction from rarer medium to the denser medium. This surface is the surface which separates two media, air and glass respectively. MN is perpendicular drawn to this surface, which is called as normal. AB is the incident ray. B is the point of incidence. BC is refracted ray. This normal MN makes angle with incident ray is angle of incidence, and it makes angle with refracted ray is angle of refraction. Here both angles are shown, that is angle of incidence as well as angle of refraction. Now if we observe this figure carefully, then you will find that angle of incidence is greater than angle of reflection. That means when there is change in medium from air to glass, instead of following this straight line path which is shown by dotted line, this ray of light AB moves along BC and it bends towards the normal. Now consider second case, in which the ray of light travels from denser medium like glass to the rarer medium like air. Here AB is incident ray, BC is refracted ray. MN is the normal to the surface, I is angle of incidence which is ABM, R is angle of refraction that is NBC. Now here refraction is from denser to rarer medium, and if you observe this figure carefully, then you observe that this angle of incidence is less than angle of refraction. That means this refracted ray BC moves away from the normal, or it's away from the normal when the refraction is from denser medium to the rarer medium. Now let us see the laws of refraction. First law we can state similar to that of reflection, that is law of coplanarity, that is incident ray, refracted ray and normal lies in the same plane. Second law, in case of refraction we define, that is Snell's law. Snell's law is stated as, for any two media, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant, and this constant is known as refractive index of the medium. Now we can write mathematically refractive index, that is sin I upon sin r is always equal to constant, and this constant we call as refractive index. Now here if we consider mu2 is the refractive index of second medium and mu1 is the refractive index of first medium, then mu2 upon mu1, that is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, which always remains constant. But refractive index is also defined in terms of velocity of light. It is the ratio of velocity of light in first medium to the velocity of light in second medium. Suppose light travels from air to glass, then refractive index of glass with respect to air is always the ratio of velocity of light in air to the velocity of light in glass. Similarly, we can write the refractive index for any pair of medium, and this is the Snell's law of refraction. Now from Snell's law, we can state the physical significance of the refractive index. If we consider the ray of light travels from rarer medium to the denser medium, that means air to glass, the refracted ray always bends towards the normal, which is as shown in this figure. Therefore, angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refraction. Therefore, refractive index is always greater than 1. But when the ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, that is glass to air, then the ray of light is always bends away from the normal. In this case, angle of incidence is less than angle of refraction. Here by mistake, the sign is different. But angle of incidence is less than angle of refraction. Therefore, ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always less than 1. Thank you.